The Montreal Canadiens have locked up Nick Suzuki to an 8-year extension. This instant analysis presented by Tylenol Rapid Release Gel Caps, rapid release for rapid relief. And of course, some relief as we're chatting with Julian McKenzie of The Athletic, the CJ Pod, among many other NHL pursuits to break down this Nick Suzuki extension. Julian, thanks so much for doing this. Let's start with Suzuki, 22 years old, coming off a 41-point campaign in a shortened 56-game season. 8 years, $63 million, a big number a lot of people are going to be looking at. What do you make of this deal when you first looked at it?
I was honestly surprised that the extension had him at an AAV below $8 million, considering what he means to the Montreal Canadiens. And we know that he'll likely be the number one center going forward. And he's kind of earned that with the way that he's played and also with the way the depth chart looks. But he's shown to be a capable NHL center from the moment that the Canadiens had him in their lineup. And going forward with the potential partnership that he could have with Cole Caulfield, Tyler Toffoli as well, and some of the other top six forwards that he could be playing with over the season, over the course of his Montreal Canadiens career, this is a guy who, offensively speaking, we could be seeing his totals go up. You mentioned, I think, like 41 points last season. That's in a shortened year. I was looking this up, I think, on Hockey Reference. Prorated, I think that goes up to about 63 points. Like, this is a guy whose offensive totals are going up. And on the defensive side, he's shown a lot of growth as well. He's proven to be dependable in his own zone as well. Maybe the faceoffs could be a little bit better, but Nick Suzuki has shown at both offense and defense, he is a player worth having for the Montreal Canadiens. So I think at the extension move money that they signed him at, I was pleasantly surprised to see the Canadiens make that move work.
Now, does this seem like a gamble for Mark Bergevin at all? Because when the new contract kicks in next season, it'll make Suzuki the team's highest paid skater outside of Carey Price, who carries a $10.5 million average. Do you see this as a gamble, or is it just expected of what's to come from Suzuki?
Well, I mean, any move that you make of that sort will always be some sort of gamble, but I think it's a gamble worth going for if you're Mark Bergevin, considering the ceiling and the upside that could be there for Nick Suzuki. This is a guy who, for better or for worse, earned comparisons to Patrice Bergeron for his two-way play last year. So I think for a guy like that, considering what other guys might be getting, I know he's like a shade above Andrei Svechnikov in Carolina, but some other forwards who are making well above $8 million, we could be looking at a point where Nick Suzuki, maybe in year two or three of this contract, it could easily be a steal. But of course, he has to ascend and continue to progress offensively and defensively as well to make those numbers work. I think if you're Mark Bergevin, looking at the tape, the quality of player that you have in Nick Suzuki, this is definitely a gamble worth taking on.
I've seen that comparison a few times now. He seems like he could be a Patrice Bergeron down the line. Obviously not there yet. No one's anointing him that quite yet, but
not
down
yet.
The line, he certainly could be that. The contract runs through 2029-30. That buys up four potential UFA years at a number south of $8 million, like we've mentioned. By 2026, Suzuki, he would become a UFA. This contract could become one of the league's biggest bargains by then. Agree or disagree?
I think if he continues to go up, I think it easily could be. Again, the fact that he didn't sign for anywhere up of north of $8 million, I'm still surprised at. And I think considering the level of play that he's able to bring to the Montreal Canadiens and the responsibilities that are going to be brought upon him, if he's able to push through all of that, it could easily be a bargain. I know a lot has been made about the fact that he's going to be in the top line position that he's in, and there's a lot that could be heaped upon him. Last year, he had the benefit of having Philippe Deneau, who was the team's best defensive center, take up some of those best matchups against some of the other team's best players. This year, he'll get a lot more pressure on that, but he'll also have Christian Dvorak, who has that experience of going up against other teams' best players if need be. Jake Evans will likely draw in as the third center, and he's even had shifts against Connor McDavid if need be as well. So I don't think the pressure that'll be applied on Nick Suzuki defensively will be nearly as great as some other people might think it to be, but there's definitely going to be more responsibilities added on to Nick Suzuki. But I think with what he's shown so far in the National Hockey League, he's proven that he's able to push through those and he's able to ascend and just be a better player for as long as we've seen with the Montreal Canadiens. So I think it has the potential of being a steal for the Montreal Canadiens going forward.
Lots of question marks from people outside the Montreal market saying, not sure about this. However, Julie McKenzie tells us that this does look like a pretty good contract. And Habs fans will probably tell you the same thing under the tweet that they sent out. I just saw a lot of W's. I saw a lot of that. Anyways, Julie, Really, really appreciate you joining us today for this instant analysis of the new Nick Suzuki contract.
Thanks for having me.